हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज शाहिद सर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इवोल्यूशन बाय स्टेजेस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट इज इवोल्यूशन। इवोल्यूशन इज अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस विच चेंजेस द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम। फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन सी दैट इवोल्यूशन ऑफ ह्यूमन। वी आर सेइंग दैट ह्यूमन्स आर इवॉल्व फ्रॉम मंकीज। सो इट इज सेड दैट इवोल्यूशन इज अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस विच चेंजेस द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स of population with passage of time. That is the definition of evolution. So in this session we will discuss about evolution and evolution by stages. How new organs are formed from primitive organism, how they evolve into a complex body, and how new organs are formed in next generation. So today's our topic is evolution by stages. First of all, evolution of eye. So first eye, which they have noticed the first eye in the planaria, and that planaria eye is a simple eye. Here you can see the structure, spot-like structure. This is the eye of planaria, very simple structure. So in this we will see evolution of eye by stages, how this eye is formed, and how from this simple eye complex structure is formed. So for animal, eye is very important, and it is complicated organ which cannot be generated by a single DNA change. The eye of animal have been created in stage after many generation. So this feature we can say from one DNA mutation it will not happen. It will take more time, more DNA changes occurs, and after that eye will be formed. And they have said that first of all eye was formed in the planaria. So from the study they have said that the first of all the eye was formed in the planaria, that is the flatworm, as we have seen that is the eye of planaria, flatworm. And that eye of flatworm is very simple structure. So the eye of planaria are very simple and are just like eye spot which detect light. Now this simple eye provide a survival advantage to the planaria. Most of the animals like insects, octopus, invertebrates, vertebrates have eyes. So mostly we can say this, mostly all the organisms are having eyes. Now what is the function of that eye? We know that it is very essential for the survival. If you are not having the eye, how can you see? If you are not able to see any enemies, so that enemy will harm you. Or if you are not able to see any food, so you cannot eat that. So eye is a very essential feature of organism's body. And we can say this, all the organism, mostly all the organisms are having the eyes. The structure of eye in above organism. So as we are discussing evolution, so here in evolution we are saying that what happened in evolution. So from primitive organism, new organism is formed. So primitive organism must have a simple structure. From that primitive organism, new organism which is formed is having the complex features, complex structure. So primitive organism, here we are talking about the planaria. First eye is found in the planaria. So the eye of planaria is very simple structure. Now other organism which are evolved from planaria may have a complex structure than the planaria. So they may have a complex eye structure. So the structure of eye in above organism is different, which suggests that the evolution of eye is an example of evolution by stages. So from that example we can say this, evolution of eye, or that evolution by stages, that prove that it is the evolution by stages. So here you can see the diagram of planaria. Now the second thing is evolution of feathers. Now in feathers, in some dinosaurs feathers could not be used for flying but provide insulation in cold weather. So it protect the animals from cold weather. So generally primitive organisms are using that feathers for protection against the cold weather. So that feathers are not for the flying. So dinosaurs are also having the feathers, but feathers of dinosaurs are not useful for the flight. Now what happened then? Later, they might become useful for flight. Presence of feathers in birds tells us that birds are closely related to the reptiles. Now, these feathers also you can see in the case of birds. Birds are having the feathers, and that feathers, they are using that feathers for the flying. So dinosaurs are also having the same structure, but dinosaurs are not using feathers for the flying. But now the evolution of dinosaur, which is maybe converted into the birds, are using these feathers for flying. So because dinosaur belongs to the reptiles, so from this we can say this dinosaurs belongs to the reptiles, because this birds are having features like the dinosaurs. Initially dinosaurs are also having the feathers, but they are not using the feathers for flying. They are using the feathers to protect from the cold weather. Now as we can see that birds are also having the feathers, same structure like the dinosaurs. So we can say this, maybe they have evolved from the dinosaurs. Now dinosaurs belongs to the reptiles, so we can say this, the ancestors of birds may be reptiles. Next thing is evolution due to artificial selection. So in this what happened? Artificially we select. So human, if we want some characters, we are doing some manipulation in the species. So what happened? A new species will be formed. So that is the evolution due to artificial selection. So artificial selection is the process by which human select traits. Traits are nothing but the characters. So human select traits useful to them for improving the quality of domesticated plants and animals. So in this what happened? Humans are doing some changes in the plants or animal structure. So new species will be formed, and that new species is not formed from the natural means. It is formed because of the artificial selection. So that evolution is said to be the evolution due to artificial selection. So it is all very well to say that very dissimilar looking structure evolved from common ancestor design. Now in right now, is there any example from that we can understand this? So yes, there is one example, the wild cabbage plant. The wild cabbage plant is a good example to understand evolution due to artificial selection. So from this, here you can see a wild cabbage, a variety. Initially this wild cabbage, only one variety is there, that is a wild cabbage. Right now you can see kohlrabi, kale, red cabbage, broccoli. These are right now you can see these varieties. So all these varieties are evolved from the wild cabbage, and this evolved because of the artificial selection, human effort. So this is said to be the evolution due to artificial selection. So wild cabbage plant have been under cultivation by farmers for 2000 years as food plant, and human have generated different vegetable from it by selection. So examples are given here. Here you can see the examples. So these all are formed from this one variety, that is wild cabbage. Thank you.